Talking about DL&W unit number 426, one of the first NKP switchers built by Electromotive Corporation, EMC, in 1935. It is a unit that worked here at Scranton. There are many photographs of it working here in the period of time from 1935 to 1947, when the Lackawanna sold it to Bethlehem Steel Company for use at their mining operations in the Ebensburg area, western Pennsylvania. And it later came under the control of the Cambria and, the C&I Railroad, which was a Bethlehem subsidiary. The local Delaware Lackawanna short line bought the unit and restored it to as much as possible the condition it was in as a Lackawanna unit of 1935. It's a real relic from the dawn of dieseldom. It worked here with steam engines its whole career. Steam lasted in Scranton for another 6 years after that unit left. So it didn't put the fires out here, but it was the first NKP switcher design that was successful. And it's going to operate on this Saturday and Sunday with running caboose trips. It'll be a very nice thing to see operate. The last time I remember it operating was in 2001.
Thank you.
It's exactly the same design as the original headlight on the locomotive. Same for the rear-facing headlight. The visor's the same, everything. It was great. That headlight was the way it looked originally. It's not the original headlight. The DL shop here in Scranton, when the unit arrived in the late 90s, tried to bring it back to its original 1935 appearance, and the headlight was a huge problem. However, CMO of the Delaware Lackawanna, Donnie Colangelo, found that a headlight was readily attainable off a DL&W MU car, and he installed those headlights on the front and rear ends of engine 426. And if you look at a picture of her in the Diesel Spotter's Guide, you'll find that she looks just like she did in 1935. Last time these two engines were together was a Conneaut in 1958.
Okay.
So that's ours.
Wow.
And she's not operable, but she was a famous excursion engine in the late 60s and into the early 70s. Part of the Steamtown collection. These engines were built 1 month apart in 1944. And they did not have brass. It was being used in the war effort. So the bells are made of iron. Now, that's why they painted the bells yellow. And if you look at any color pictures of the engines built during the war, you'll see they had the yellow bell. It's kind of disappointing when you look at it because it's a beautiful face with like somebody has a terrible hat on after getting all gussied up, you know? But they're two beautiful machines. Here's 765.
Get the oxygen bottle, the new one, out of the tool car, and have it standing, or just change that way, or it gets dead. It's like down to 200 pounds.
22-car train from Allentown to Pittston, unassisted, on the 22nd and 23rd of August.
Yeah, I saw a video of it.
She is the finest operating steam locomotive in the United States.
That is true.
And in my opinion, growing up when they were still in service, the finest type of steam locomotive of any kind.
They're definitely the most versatile. Absolutely. I'm not going to need that on the plate yet, right?
Right now, though, all you need is a fine bar or something to get the
765, conductor Stanley, over.
Stand by.
Thank you.
Thank you. back this out again.
Thank you.
Thank you.